Yes, you can start.
Okay, so first of all, thank you for hosting this event, and I would like to say good evening, guten Tag, guten Abend, and all the other phrases to everybody who attended to this meeting. I will speak about multilingual Power BI reports in the next 25-30 minutes, so if there are any questions, please interrupt me and I'll try to answer it. So let's start. First of all, who I am. So I'm speaking from Budapest, Hungary, Central Europe. I'm a Power BI expert and trainer. Typically, I'm just doing a lot of Power BI reports and data warehouse and data lake development in our small company for different companies, for big multinational companies in Hungary and around the world. And I also do a lot of trainings, my custom Power BI workshops, and also Dashboard in a Day ones. I have more than 10 years experience in Microsoft BI stack and much longer experience in different software development. So what is in the next 25 minutes? First, I will show what is the metadata translation, which is coming from the SQL Server Analysis Services tabular translation feature. Officially, this is the solution for multilingual reports nowadays from Microsoft, and you will see that there are some basic steps to achieve this goal, but I believe this is not the best solution. And then I will show a solution which was implemented in the last one and a half years for different companies. It works. It has also some limitations, but it is much more general than the metadata translation. So first of all, what is this metadata translation, which is the official way to create a multilingual report? First of all, what is multilingual report? It means that very typical for a big multinational company that there are English people, German people, Spanish people, et cetera, and they need their own language version of the same report. So the very basic idea to create multilingual reports is to create a German one, a Spanish one, an Italian one, but in this case, you will have a lot of reports, and the maintenance cost for doing this so many reports is really high. It is not a good solution. So somehow, if you would like to have one Power BI report which supports multiple languages, then you should find a solution for it, and this is the multilingual Power BI report. And for this, Microsoft suggested to use the metadata translation. It is a really good thing on one side because it works in some cases, but it is not the ultimate best solution. So how it works? So I just would like to show it immediately in a real project. So I have, for example, here a Power BI desktop with a nice dashboard, and I have in the external tools a tool called Tabular Editor. Tabular Editor, I am sure most of you are knowing. It is a good open source solution from a Danish guy. And it shows me the same data that is available in the desktop file. It shows the tabular model from this Power BI file. And this tabular model, you could see that there are two different translations, one is English and one is German. And if I just show you, these are the tables in this data model. It is a sales-oriented model, not really interested what does it mean. And if I would like to check how the German translation looks like, I'm just going here to the tabular editor, select the German one, I'm just use my old German knowledge. Maybe some of the translation are not the best, but maybe it's good or not good. But you see that based on my selection, I could see the table names and field names could be translated to any other languages. If you add here additional translations, of course, you could add multiple translations to the same tabular model. And then you just click on the save button, close this tabular editor, and you will realize that here I am in Power BI Desktop, and I couldn't see how it looks like in German or any other translations, because Power BI Desktop itself doesn't support this whole technology. It was the first surprise me that now we have metadata translation, you could do it, but you are not able to see anything in Power BI Desktop. Furthermore, you are not able to see any translation, anything in the Power BI service if you publish this report to the shared capacity, for example, to your My Workspace or any workspace which is on the shared capacity. So I just published this report to the shared capacity. Intentionally, I changed my language to German, and I don't see any changes in the field names or the table names here. As you see, everything remained English. And the only way it works, if you deploy the report on a dedicated capacity, for example, I just created the screenshots in a Power BI embedded capacity in our company, or I check this technology in a customer who uses premium capacity. In premium capacity or embedded capacity, so some kind of dedicated capacity, as you see, it works. So now the field names and the table names change to German, and if you see the titles here or some of the other fields change to German. So all this metadata translation works only if the report is deployed to a dedicated capacity. This is the first limitation of this technology. On one side, it's good that if you create such a report and deploy to a premium capacity, and then you share this report in Microsoft Teams, for example, here I just shared with a Power BI tab, you see that it is German also, and if I shared it via the new Power BI app in the Microsoft Teams application, it also could handle it. So looks nice because, for example, in our company, most of our users supports this Microsoft Teams-based Power BI reports. They like to navigate within Teams and check the report and go back and chat with the colleagues. So it's fine that it works within Teams, but it needs a dedicated capacity. And there are some other limitations that I realized that, for example, I just renamed one of my fields. As you see in the right side of the screen, intentionally I translated a product category in a bad way, product canal. It's a bad translation, but we'll see why I did it earlier. But somehow I just rename it to category, and from that moment it won't work for any kind of multilingual usage. So you should use only those fields which are available on the fields list, and you mustn't modify it, because from that moment the translation, the automatic translation, doesn't work. And the good thing is that because it is only works in a dedicated capacity, and if the dedicated capacity has an XML read-write endpoint enabled, then it is possible to update the translations, not just via the Power BI file. So every time I could go to tabular editor, modify the translation, then save back to the Power BI file, and then publish to the Power BI service, but it could take a lot of time, especially if the Power BI file is really big. But if you just go here and fix this product category translation, and it is possible to publish the whole metadata translation to the Power BI service using the XML read-write endpoint, and in this case you don't have to publish again every time the whole data model. So how it looks like in tabular editor, you are able to connect to an XML read-write endpoint. Here is a workspace connection string, so this is the XML endpoint. I just selected a database, a dataset, and then deploy only the model structure which contains the translations. And then at the end, I just see this product category in the Power BI service So it is also possible to upload something from your tabular editor. So my whole idea to do a Power BI multilingual report and using this metadata translation, my opinion, it is only good if you have just fields and drag and drop these fields and show simple charts and
Parents?
For example, yes.
I think we have one first question
yes.
in our chat, and they are the question, manual translation only, your own translations?
Yeah, for my situation, it was enough to do it manually. Of course, it is possible to export this file and using other tools to create these translations, I believe. I heard that there are some tools which could help you using the Azure Cognitive Services or something like this, but I haven't tried it, I have to say.
Okay, thanks.
For me, it was only a situation to check it is good solution or should I use my previously created implemented solution. And my opinion, it is good for very simple situation like this, that, for example, the title is good for me to automatically create it from the field names or have a tooltip which shows me the data in the automatically translated way. But if I would like to have a much more general, broader solution, I believe it is not enough. So that's why I created a solution. 1.5 years ago, a German-Swedish company asked us, our company, that could you show something how to create a multilingual report, because we don't want to create English, German, Danish and all the other languages. I would like to have only one PBX5 with all the languages. So we started with the colleagues a solution, and I tried to show it in a community way how it works. So first of all, we need a languages table. And the very first thing that we created is a translation label for the labels, titles, button text, because in a normal report, there are a lot of labels, the title of the report page or a title of a visual or a button text, etc. So at first we tried to solve this issue. So we created a translation table. This table was implemented in an Excel file, so we just imported this Excel file. You see here are a lot of codes, for example, for country, and there are some different translations based on the different language codes. And then after we loaded this data, we just added a slicer to the report. And because typically a report contains not just one report page, rather multiple pages, so we use the sync slicer to say that every page should be synced. So if I select German, for example, a language, I will see all the pages in German. Maybe not every page will contain this slicer. Maybe in this demo, only the first two pages contains a language slicer, but all the pages are filtered for a selected language. Then the next step was that in order to show something on the screen, for example, a label, a title, or a button text, I should somehow do it in a dynamic way. So if I select something on the slicer, it should be dynamically changed. And in Power BI, it is the measure. So at first I realized that if I would like to have multilingual labels, I need measures for every different labels. For example, here there is a category. If I would like to have a category label measure, I have to write something. This is one way to implement this measure, but I believe there are at least two, three other ways to get from this translation table, get the appropriate translation based on the selected language. If you have only one, two, three different labels, it is not a big deal to copy paste and create some measures. But if you have a real project where there are tons of measures and tons of labels and with tons of measures, one solution is to copy and paste every day. But on the other hand, I believe it is I'm a lazy developer, and lazy developer doesn't like to implement so many things manually. So I just created a solution, which is based on this one, which uses the tabular editor. Tabular editor, as we see earlier, I can open it using the external tools. And there is a really, really good feature in Tabular Editor that you are able to write scripts. The scripts are very similar to C Sharp, and because I'm also a .NET developer, I could write a script which is very similar to a C Sharp. I just would like to show the script itself. So the author of this tabular editor has several scripts available on the GitHub, and one of the solutions from him was that if you have a tabular separated file, a TSV file, then you are able to read this TSV file, and then you could create measures based on this TSV file. So I just used his example, I modify for my purposes, and this TSV file is the exported from the original label translation Excel file. So I've got only a text file, I read it, and every row is checked that maybe there is a measure that I should create it. If yes, then I create it in the display folder translations, automatically generated based on a template. I just created all these measures instead of typing one by one the translation measures. So for example, if I just execute it, it takes some seconds and read the file and regenerate all the different measures. So in the measures table, in the translations, I've got all the required labels for me. And then it's no problem if I just at this time reload the modifications, then it will be no problem to have all the translation measures instead of just typing or copy pasting. So that was one idea from me to have a solution for it.
You have another question.
Yes.
A fully implementation translation project would require currency conversion also,
yes,
wouldn't it?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, for currency conversion, I believe I could answer it better at the end of the session, because I will show something on calculation groups, and calculation group could be a currency conversion solution, if it's a good answer for you.
It wasn't my question, but I wanted to bring it in, so it's good to hear, and I don't forget it okay. To ask you at the end. Okay.
Okay, so now we have all the labels and all the measures to automatically find the translation based on the selected language. And then the next step is to set the properties. Until now, if you have a report, you just go to a title text or a button text or any other properties, and you hard-coded the text. Now you have to use a measure, and this is called the expression-based formatting. You should select here that this label will be used for this title, for example. And then you should go one by one on the visuals, on the report pages, that you should set all the properties using these automatically generated labels. And the final solution looks nice. I will show it very soon. But there are some properties which doesn't support this technique, this expression-based formatting. So I should find out another solution. For example, a normal card with a category label doesn't have this expression-based formatting. So I just modified it. Not a big difference for the business, but in this case, I just move from the category label to the title, and the title could be multilingual. Or, for example, the sales overview was just a label, a text box in the original report. I modified it to use as a title, and the title was possible to use this expression, this formatting. And very similarly, there are several properties, unfortunately, which doesn't support this expression-based formatting. For example, the axis, the X and Y axis has this title here in the screens, and it is not supported, so I just remove the these translations. If it really needed, then with standalone labels, it is possible to reproduce, but I believe it's not really important. Very similarly, on the legend, the title of the legend is not supported, the expression-based formatting at this moment. And some other stuff that I did, for example, you remember there was this tooltip I just created as a report page tooltip, and report page tooltip could be now multilingual. So I tried to simulate some of the original report using this expression-based formatting, using the different measures to have a multilingual report, especially for the labels, titles, etc. And one of the typical things, if you ever implemented a Windows or web application or mobile application which supports multilingual, it is a typical thing also in not just in Power BI, but also in any other multilingual developments, that if you have a not enough wide label, then some of the translation could be too long for the label. And here you see that sales overview in Italian, it's too long and it shows in a bad way. So it's really important if you have a multilingual report to have much wider labels, because some of the languages supports a longer name instead of just the English, which is a very compact language. And maybe this is the time I just show you how it looks like in reality, V2. So here is a report, here is the slicer, I just select, for example, German, and then everything is immediately changed to German, because all the different properties set based on this expression-based formatting. So I believe it looks nice, the end user likes it. The only problem here is that, as you see, we have report page names, and we would like to have multilingual report page names, and at this moment it doesn't allow, neither by the software itself, it is not possible to write a measure, expression-based formatting, nothing. So another solution should be also found here. And the solution is that I hidden all the pages, add a new page. It is called home. Home, maybe it is a well-known word for the other languages, so I believe maybe it is possible to understand that this is the first page that will be visible in a Power BI report. And I just created a welcome screen or something like this, where you could select your favorite language and some buttons, and the buttons will navigate you to the appropriate page. So here the main message, it is not possible to have multilingual report page names. One possibility to remain in English, for example, or doing something like this here, this navigation bar. So how it looks like in reality. So here is this page. Intentionally, this page is not working. I will speak why it not work. So here I just select something Deutsch and click on this button, and it will navigate me to the Verkaufsübersicht. So it looks nice, works, and maybe it could simulate that you are using not just a normal Power BI report, but something which is much more like a web application.
Ferenc?
Yes?
We have, it's not a question, it's only a mark from the chat that the labels are still in English. I think you will go on this with the months names and.
Okay, I see. I have to say in this session I won't show it, but for the data to be able to multilingual, it's much easier to compare to have multilingual labels on your screen. So if you would like to multilingual data like month names or currency conversion or whatever else, for example, you have a product category list and you would like to show the display the categories in German. If you select German, it is also possible. In this case, you have to duplicate or triplicate your dimension records to have translation for English, German, etc. So I have to say in this session, I just focus only for the UI elements, how to be able to multilingual the different elements, not just the data. Is it a good answer?
I think.
Yeah, okay. So the next problem and this whole story that I just mentioned until now, it works fine for several visuals, but if you arrive to a table or a matrix, then you will realize that it is much harder to multilingual than any other visuals. So what is the problem? You see that there are column headers, there are row headers, and somehow you should immediately modify the rows and column headers based on your selections. And I realized that there are several methods to do this. I just select one method, which was implemented in this project I mentioned earlier, that, for example, for a table where there are columns, we created a new table with the column header names in all the different languages. If it is a matrix, so we have row and column headers, then we created another table also containing all the rows, row header names. In this example, I will just show a simple table with the different column names. And what I just would like to show it how it looks like in reality. So it is an absolutely typical report. At this moment, it is a normal report. You see, I just drag and drop some measures and fields. And because it is just measures and fields, it is not possible to use any techniques that ensure that this will be multilingual. Rather, we had to create this special table where I have all the column names and in English, German, Italian, and French. So I have a translation table for the column names, if it is a matrix for the columns and the row names. And I have to say, maybe we should create such special translation tables for different kind of tables, matrices. So if you have a report with two different kind of tables, then you need multiple tables to do this translation. So it's not a very simple thing. So how it looks like. So we just drag and drop for the columns this special table, the names, and we wrote a special measure, which based on the selected name, it immediately find out what should be done. So what does it mean in summary? You have only one measure, and this one measure will calculate all the cell values based on the which column should be calculated in this table. If it is a matrix, then it will be a more complex things, which row, which column header should be calculated as a measure here. So it's not very simple to write it, but it is possible. And how it looks like, I just would like to show it's much easier. So finally, I just click here. You see that it is now a matrix. In the matrix, the row is only an identifier from a table. The columns are coming from this translation table, which contains the different translation for English, German, Italian, and French, And there is one measure which calculates the different cell values. It will calculate for order ID, order date, order priority, all the other stuffs. So if I just click here and show how it looks like, you see that it is a very big switch. And based on the current column, it find out what should be calculated and show the same data as previously when it was six, seven different columns instead of just one measure. So this technique could be used. You see that the dates are good, the text columns are good, you see the numbers are good. The only problem with this approach, or it could be solved, of course, in docs using the format, is that the numeric field has at this moment two digits here, and two digits here. But for order ID, it is just a whole number, so it doesn't need the two digits. So using some kind of format thing or something else, it is possible to solve it. But this was the moment that I realized that this solution is good to solve some issues with these tables, but it doesn't support that the different columns could have different formatting options. And finally, I will show a solution for this also. But before we go ahead, I would like to just show that somebody could ask that if it is only one measure, how I could use a conditional formatting. And you see that it is not a problem. I just wrote a measure for font color, background color, or icon. Different measure could be used for the same one measure here. So, for example, for the icon, I wrote another measure called detail table conditional formatting icon, and it will calculate that when the total cost column is rendered, then how the different rules should be implemented when this icon, or this icon could be visible. So this solution is good in this case for conditional formatting also. And finally, as somebody asked this currency conversion, and I mentioned that maybe we will use some calculation groups. So my problem was this different columns have different formatting options or strings, and how I could implement it. So I just tried out, and it works that a typical thing, what is calculation group if somebody doesn't know it? Maybe you heard about it, that if you have a measure and you would like to write it for year to date, month to date, quarter to date, previous year, then you have to write a lot of measures. Then if you have another measure and you would like to have a year to date, quarter to date, month to date, etc., then you have to write another tons of measures. Maybe you could automatize it using the tabular editor scripting functionality, but it's much better if you use the calculation groups, because calculation group on high level is some kind of templating stuff. So you could write so-called calculation items, so different formulas, which uses a measure called selected measure, and you could use this calculation group and calculation items for different measures instead of writing a lot of measures. So I just realized that maybe I could try out this calculation group and how it looks like. So I did it only for English and German for this demo. So I created one calculation group with all items. These are the English items, and these are the German items. So all the columns, which was implemented earlier in a table, now everything is only in a calculation group. And you see that, for example, here is a measure, like the selected language code is something like this. If it is English, then please show the total sales. If it is not English, it will return blank. So for total sales, it will show value only if the selected language is English. If it is German or any other language, it won't show anything. So very simple thing. Yes. Can you repeat your question? Okay, so the format string is important. You could set a format string for the columns. And using this technique, I just show what is the result. So for example, Deutsch. Select something, then go to a detail page, and it automatically shows the tables in German, although it is coming from a calculation group. So just to have a quick conclusion, and then we could speak all the questions and answers. Only two things remained. So using this technique, I could translate the labels, the tables. Using a calculation group, I could set dynamically the format strings. But after you upload this whole file to the Power BI service, it is not so easy to find out which how to configure the default language. For example, Markus would like to use German and Catherine would like to use the Deutsch version. How she or he able to select the default language? And our solution was this persistent filter. So if you select a language in the slicer and wait until at first time till 60 seconds, then Power BI automatically persists the slicer and filter states. So after 60 seconds, after I selected the German language, you see that I close my browser, open it, and shows the same report in German. Then I click on the reset to default button and it goes back to the English version. So our solution is very simple to select everybody his favorite language. Please select your language, wait only at the first time till 60 seconds, and then everything will be stored in Power BI service. And it remains after you upload newer and newer versions of your report, because other versions we tried with personal bookmarks and other techniques, any other techniques was bad for this situation, especially for us. And one limitation that I would like to show here, and then I will end my session, is that if you pin a visual from your report which uses this expression-based formatting, then it automatically hard-coded the language on the pinned visual. So here you see that this is a visual from a report where the language was selected for German. Here an English language was selected. And after you pinned to a dashboard, then nothing could happen. It always remains German or English. You are not able to do it in a multilingual way. So this solution is working only for the reports, not for the dashboard in the Power BI service.
Okay, oh, next question. I think it was a question slide. Okay, now you can see.
Okay, so back to the currency conversion stuff. I believe the currency conversion could be solved by a calculation groups, because the calculation group, for every calculation item, you could define a dynamic format string. Like I defined these different columns was one is date, one is two digits, one is a whole number without any digits. So for currency conversion to show, for example, in euro or a US dollar or any other kind of currencies, you could define these format strings in the calculation items. I believe I saw at least one or two blog posts around the internet on this topic. Okay, Frank asked that why is it this whole topic is better than the metadata translation? For me, the metadata translation looks like that it is good if you do only that you drag and drop the different fields to the visuals and say that I won't do any customization, only just drag and drop the fields, and then it works in premium or embedded situation, not more, but most of our customers doesn't have premium. So for us, it is also a big limitation that it works only with premium or embedded or dedicated capacities. And the other stuff is, for example, you just have a label on the report, a title of the report or something which is not just filled from the field list, then there is no solution for using this metadata translation, or you have to create such tables which contains the report title and all the other labels which are not visual. So I don't want to say that metadata translation is a bad thing. I believe it is very limited for if you would like to more customized, much comprehensive multilingual report, I believe you should go ahead and do something with Power Query Index. That's the official answer from Microsoft at this moment.
Okay. Any more questions?
Okay. If we have no more questions, I will stop the recording. Maybe we get afterwards some questions if I have stopped the recording. So.